Hello. Today's video is about when a narcissistic parent is dying. For those of you who follow my blog, I do apologize. You're basically going to be hearing a repeat of that blog entry. Sorry for the repeat. The thing is that not everybody who follows me on YouTube follows my blog, and since this is a very important topic, I felt I should cover it in both arenas. So, again, I do apologize for the repeat. At the time I'm making this video, my father is currently in the ICU on life support. He's dying from leukemia. I knew this was a very likely scenario when I went into contact with him earlier this year before his leukemia diagnosis. He's had a lot of health problems for a long time, and he's 79 now. I prepared the best I could. I prayed and I thought about what would I do if this happened. Should I resume the relationship with my parents, even knowing it would probably just get worse at the end of their lives? Could I tolerate that physically and mentally? Should I just stay away no matter what? And I also wondered how I would handle the pressure from outsiders telling me to go when I knew I shouldn't. I really didn't know how much pressure there was going to be. I've had people coming out of the woodwork telling me to go to the hospital and see him, put my feelings aside so he can die in peace. I've only got one set of parents. Things like that. It's been rough, to say the least. This often happens when a narcissistic parent is dying, and you need to be prepared for it as well, because it's not just me. To start with, pray. Ask God to show you what you should do if and when your narcissistic parent becomes terminally ill. Ignore advice from everybody when that time comes. God is the only one who knows best what you should do. Let Him guide you. Also ask Him to give you whatever it is you will need at that time. You know, wisdom, strength, courage, whatever, because you're going to need a lot of help to get through this time, especially if you end up opting to be in a caregiver type role. Definitely stay close to God. Talk with Him often. Let Him strengthen and comfort you, because you're going to need those things more than you ever have in your life. Ignore the pressure from everyone. You do what you believe God wants you to do and ignore everybody else. They haven't been in your situation and they don't understand it. That doesn't prevent them from judging it, however. Just ignore them. You have to answer to God, not people. And besides, you'll never please people anyway. You could become your parents' full-time caregiver and people would still criticize you, saying you're not doing enough. Don't hesitate to block people's phone numbers, emails, or social media. I know this sucks. It hurts cutting out your own family and friends. But sometimes you do have to protect yourself, and this is one way to do that. It'll also hurt less than allowing them to fill up your phone, your inbox, with hurtful, manipulative messages. Also, be aware that they might find other ways to access you that you hadn't thought of. One of my cousins accessed me through her dead mother's Facebook account recently. That was a surprise. Didn't see that coming. Cling on to what you know is right, no matter what. I know it's awful when your parent is dying and you know beyond a shadow of a doubt you can't say goodbye. It's painful for you and it makes you feel like a terrible person. But you aren't. Galatians 6:7 says, "Be not deceived. God is not mocked, for whatsoever man soweth, that he shall also reap." In cases like being raised by a narcissistic parent, cases like mine, this is what's happening. They're reaping the awful harvest they have sown by being abusive for my entire life. Don't let people tell you how to feel either. Even well-meaning people may do this. They may say silly things like, "You can't be mad at the flying monkeys right now. You've got too much else on your plate." Okay, thanks. You know what you feel. Acknowledge your feelings and deal with them however you feel is appropriate. Also, have realistic expectations. If you do opt to go say goodbye to your dying narcissistic parent, don't expect a happy ending. I haven't once heard of any narcissist having an epiphany or apologizing for their behavior, even on their deathbed. In fact, quite the opposite. I've heard some pretty terrible stories of how cruel they can be to their children until their dying breath. If you're willing to see your parent, to give that parent the gift of dying in peace, or because it will help you somehow to say goodbye, then by all means, go. Do it while leaning on God to help you stay strong, even when the abuse continues. If at all possible, also go when no one else is there, especially the ones who have harassed and chained you. We're also going to have to think about the funeral. Do you plan to go? If so, it can get ugly. Even funerals are not off limit to some people. Can you handle confrontations? Can you handle being shunned? It may just be too much in the light of losing your parent. Visiting the cemetery after everyone has gone home may be a much better option for you. Lastly, don't expect anything normal about grieving your narcissistic parent's death. The death of a narcissist adds a lot of complexity to the already difficult grief process. Not only are you losing a parent, you're losing the last shred of any hope that things might be better one day. You're losing the chance of ever having closure. You'll grieve that your relationship was so toxic and your parent wasn't the parent you needed. You're also going to feel relief because the abuse is finally over, and then guilt because you feel that relief. You can't fully prepare for all the things you're going to feel, and it's going to hit you hard. Try not to judge how you feel. Just accept that you feel as you do, and you're okay. If you opt to talk about your feelings, speak with only supportive and understanding friends or relatives. Anyone else is going to judge you harshly and not understand. Journal about your feelings. Read other stories about how they got through this tough time. And don't rush the grief. Take whatever time you need to get through it all. And most of all, talk to God a lot. He's there for you and he wants to help you, so let him. Thank you for watching.